Good afternoon. This work has been carried out at the Laboratory of Experimental Ophthalmology in the University of Murcia. Optic neurosotomy is a derivative site, and cross ultrasection is a derivative site to ganglion cells. In other studies from our laboratory, it was demonstrated that in rat, the temporal course of ganglion cell degeneration by ophthalmology is influenced by the lesion type, cross or transection. And after both optic nerve lesions, different branches of the apoptotic pathway and are well regulated in the injured ganglion cells. This pathway converges on the activation of the effector caspase 3. When caspase 3 is activated, it cleaves targeted proteins and apoptosis is executed. But in mice, is the temporal course of ganglion cell loss the same after crossing and after severing the optic nerve? And are ganglion cells dying by apoptosis? To answer this question, we set the following objectives. To analyze quantitatively and topographically the temporal course of ganglion cell loss after unilateral optic nerve cross or transection in mice, and in the same retinas to study the number and distribution of active caspase 3 positive ganglion cells. To read these objectives, it's very important to identify ganglion cell. The most common techniques are tracing them from the superior colliculi and BN3A immunodetection. To quantify ganglion cells, we have developed automatic routines that allow us to count all BN3A positive ganglion cells in the retina of rat and mouse. This graph shows the total number of BN3A positive ganglion cells counted automatically in albino and pigmented rat and mice. As we can see, the number of BN3A positive ganglion cells in albino mouse is about 48,000 per retina. Once we know the number of ganglion cells, it is important to know their distribution in the retina. For this, we use a show density map. In this map, retinal ganglion cell densities is expressed by a code of increasing color, from low densities represented by cool colors to high densities illustrated with warm colors. In this slide, we can see a photomontage of a mouse retina showing BN3A positive ganglion cells, and to the right it corresponding a show density map. To identify the apoptotic cell, active caspase 3 was immunodetected, and active caspase 3 were manually quantified. The distribution of apoptotic cells was performed using neighbor maps, as we can see in this slide. This tool is very useful to determine the spatial distribution of a small cell population. One point represents one cell, and the color indicates the number of neighbors that this cell has in a radius of 0.16 millimeters. Cool colors indicate a low number of neighbors, and one higher number of neighbors. For our work, we use adult albino mice that were divided into groups, tracing from the superior colliculum or no tracing. The tracing was performed 1 week before injury, because this is the time that the tracer requires to read the ganglion cell from the superior colliculum. Then, animals were subjected to optic nerve cross and to optic nerve transection. Both injuries were done at the same distance from the optic disc, 0.5 millimeters, and always to the left of the nerve. Animals were sacrificed and increased in time post-lesion, from 1 to 10 days for the animal that were no traced, and at 4 days in the case of traced animal, because it is at this moment when we found the peak of active caspase 3 expression. Next, the retinas were dissected as flat mode. In whole retinas, BN3A and active caspase 3 were double immunodetected. Next, the whole retinas were photographed for each signal, and we studied the colocalization of BN3A, caspase 3, and the tracer, and the total population and retinal distribution of surviving BN3A positive ganglion cells and of apoptotic active caspase 3 ganglion cells. This modification is observed OHST, caspase 3 and BN3A signal in the same frame from a sodomized retina. In this merged image, we can see that the expression of active caspase 3 always colocalized with the tracer. So after a sodomy, caspase 3 is expressed by ganglion cells. With respect to the colocalization of caspase 3 and brilliant 3A, we can see that when the signal of caspase 3 is low, the ganglion cell still express brilliant 3A. However, when the expression of caspase 3 increases, the brilliant 3A loss. For this result, we conclude that after optic nerve astotomy, active caspase 3 is expressed only in ganglion cells. As the expression of active caspase 3 increases, the expression of brilliant 3A decreases. Thus, the loss of brilliant 3A expression marks the death of ganglion cells. In this graph is represented the number of ganglion cells at different lines for optic nerve transaction and optic nerve crash. As we can see, after both lesions, retinal ganglion cell loss adjusts to a sigmoid curve. This loss is first significant at day 3, when 20% of the ganglion cells have died. From day 4 till day 7, ganglion cell loss is exponential. During this phase, 50% of ganglion cells die. From 8 to 10 days, ganglion cell loss slowed down. During these days, a further 10% of ganglion cells die. In this graph, it shows the number of active caspase 3 at different times, both optic nerve transection and optic nerve crash. As we can see, after both lesion, active caspase 3 positive ganglion cells are observed from 1 to 10 days. The temporal expression of active caspase 3 follows a peak curve. At day 3, when ganglion cells loss is first significant, there is a significant increase of active caspase 3 positive ganglion cells. The peak of active caspase 3 occurs at day 4, when the exponential loss of ganglion cell starts. The ratio of ganglion cell loss and number of active caspase 3 at 4 days is 2. For each 2 lost ganglion cells, one active caspase 3 ganglion cell is detected. Finally, when we analyze the topography of ganglion cell loss and caspase 3 expression, we observe that ganglion cell loss, it is first significant at day 3, and it is diffused across the retina. And at this standpoint, there is a significant increase of active caspase 3 all across the retina. During the exponential phase of ganglion cell loss, active caspase 3 ganglion cells are observed across the retina, parallel with the diffuse loss of ganglion cells. From 8 to 10 days, in agreement with the quantitative data, the loss of ganglion cells and the expression of active caspase 3 is very small. The conclusion of this work are, in mice, the loss of brilliant 3A expression marks the death of ganglion cells. The temporal course of ganglion cell death and of active caspase 3 is the same after optic nerve crash and after optic nerve transection. Retinal ganglion cell death is diffuse and affects the whole retina. Accordingly, active caspase 3 ganglion cells are observed across the retina. The peak of active caspase 3 occurs at day 4, when the exponential loss of ganglion cell starts. At this time point, one active caspase 3 positive ganglion cell is detected for each ganglion cell that die. This indicates that at least half of the ganglion cell die by apoptosis after optic nerve astotomy. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions.